everybody, welcome to Board Game Heaven. Today I'm going to do an unboxing of Orcs Must Die, the board game by Petersen Games. And as you can see, I've received my goodies from the Kickstarter and I can't wait to show you what's inside. So let's go and have a look at the unboxing of Orcs Must Die, the board game. Okay, Orcs Must Die, the board game. This game comes in two editions, the Unchained Edition and the Order Edition. And basically, the game is exactly the same, albeit that in the Order Edition you're playing the good guys versus the bad guys, just like in the video game. And in the Unchained Edition, it's the other way around. You're playing the orcs and then the ogres, the hordes of evil, and you're protecting your domain from the do-gooders. So it's a reverse kind of thing, and if you have both, you could combine both games and play a team versus team game. Now this is a tower defense game, and just like the video game, if you have played it, if you haven't, I recommend it. It's really a lot of fun. And well, I'll start with the Order Edition first, and then I'll unbox the Unchained Edition. So this is the back side of the Order Edition with all the contents listed on here. Let's go and have a look. Okay, so what do we have here? This is a picture, which is handy, of the plastic insert with all the characters in it. So if you're unboxing this and you've played this and you've forgotten which model goes where, then this is a handy reference to show you where they belong. That's the first time I've seen that. Now, a rather hefty rulebook. But it's nicely bound. It almost looks like an actual book instead of one that's stapled together. So here is all the contents of the box. Summary. The rules. And they're well illustrated. So I'm hoping that this will be easy to learn. But there's quite a lot of rules, so this is going to be quite a read. But there's a frequently asked questions here, I see, so that's good. So about, 55, 56 pages of stuff to read with some nice artwork. Well done. There's another book, which is thinner, of maps. So these are all maps that you can play and you can vary, because it says here any tile, so you can mix and match and make all these maps different every time. So plenty to go around and some empty pages so you can draw in your own designs. Here are the player boards, which have a really nice artwork on the backside. So this is Maximilian, the War Mage, known from the game. A new hero called Ivy, who is an elf. Cygnus. And Gabriella. Here is a tile for the movement and the actions of the bad guys. Handy. This is the Rift board. Okay, well, the tokens. Of course, you're gonna score lots of skulls, just like in a video game. So there's skulls in here, there's several other tokens, different illustrations on the front and the back for some of these. And then there are the minis. Let's just have a look. Well, I'm not sure if you can see very well, but I think these are quite nice. They're well detailed. They look exactly like the characters in the video game. And they're the usual size for miniatures. And they have these hexagonal bases for the heroes, it seems. And here is the elf archer hero. And they have round bases for the enemies, and they are all green. One of the orcs. I'm liking these. They really remind me of the video game. They look great. Okay, let's just go ahead and skip the rest. So, see what else is there in here. A decent insert, at least, to keep everything in place. A big pile of dice. Always a fan of dice. So let's quickly have a look. Alright. So, dice with all these icons on them. I hope the camera will zoom. Yes, there it is. So this, I think, is roll for speed, forward attacks. This is a brain. I still don't know what they do because I haven't read the rules yet. Just opened the box and a couple of blank sides in different colors, and a green one with some skulls and a healing icon. Yep, and yellow ones. So all these symbols on here, they look to be pretty clear. I mean, once you know what each symbol does, that seems to be very obvious. Here's a frost die. And there's plenty of them, so that's always a good thing. Another hero on a bigger base, Maximilian. And Cygnus. Now, some cards here. These are small cards, as you can see. And there are some weapon cards in here. These are a couple of cheat games. Oh, armies, it says here. I'll have a look at those later. Trinkets, gear, yep. And these are traps, and that's what the game is all about, setting up traps all over the place to lure your enemies in, trying to defend the rift. Now a big bag of bigger enemies. Let's have a look at what's in here. So here is a big troll. Also nice, and this is all hard plastic, which I love because I've had games with the bendy plastic and I'm not a huge fan of that, although, you know, they won't break easily, but this is sturdy enough, this won't break. This is nice. So I'm quite happy with the quality. Here's an ogre with this huge club, a mean grin on his face. Another troll, and another ogre. What else do we have? Some gnolls. No, actually these are, what are they called again? The runners, you know, the quick ones. It'll come to me. Kobolds, they're kobolds. And another troll. Another ogre, plenty of these. Great, more kobolds. Is there anything else in here? Ah, yes, there is another orc. Is that the only one? And another orc, yeah, with the sword. Yep, that was, the rest is all kobolds and orcs. I'll just take this out quickly so I can get to this easier. Okay, the tiles, and this is a big pack of tiles, rather heavy. Nice illustrated bag. So let's open these, and I'll open the cards as well and show you everything that's inside. Okay, so I've opened up the tiles and the cards. I'll quickly show you the cards first. So we have here the player's weapons. There's Ivy's Blessed Bow, and there's three of each, and they go up in level. And as you can see at the bottom, it tells you that what they can do, they give you better benefits, more damage, more dice to roll. So, and they're double-sided, but they're the same on both sides. And you'll also notice the gems here have a different color. I'm assuming that the white gem is the first level, and green and blue indicates tougher levels. So Cygnus has his stick, his staff. And he starts with an iron staff, then he gets a copper staff and an armored staff. Then Gabriella's Staff of Domination. And Maximilian's medium crossbow, heavy crossbow, and arbalest. So, okay, that's the weapons that they're carrying. Then we have three decks. We have a deck of gear, a deck of traps, and a deck of armies. I'll just quickly go through them. So they're all like this on the back, with the exception of the gem here that shows you the level, I'm assuming. So, and the white ones. So let's start with those first. We have an alchemist satchel, flame pendant, four leaf clover, last stand ring, mirror armor, a pity party, a pointed stick, a potion of giant strength, potion of speed, a spark plug, a vegetable of mending, a wooden stone, brass knuckles, candle holder, contradiction gem, cool mint flavor trinket, a dwarf grenade, a glowing snake skull, a hero potion, an inferno stone, the let freedom ring, the schadenfreude ring, steel ring, a stone of stoning, a talking skull ring, a thunder sack, and a thunder stone, a toadstone amulet, another vegetable of mending, higher level, burning coal, the dragon shield, and some of this art you'll recognize from the video game as well, the dwarf rocket launcher, the gnome repair kit, an icicle, the joy buzzer, a little alchemy kit, a lucky rock, oh, look at how happy it is, a magic brick, awesome, a mithril disc, a mood gem, octopipes, a pewter ring, a rabbit's foot, steel-toed boots, an unholy hand grenade, an uranium ring, a Viking shield, and a wander wand. So those are all the gear cards that you get with the order edition. Okay, next the traps, which is, you know, the thing in this game. You place traps, a lot of them. So we've got poison needles, and they are also in several levels. The spike trap that we know from the video game. The jack-in-the-box with the decoy artwork. The tar pit. The arrow wall. The defibrillator ring. The coin forge. The quarter pounder. The eighth pounder, the half pounder, and the pound pounder. There's a disco ball, how cool is that? A healing fountain, the overloader drops rocks, the blade wall with the swirling axes, the ballista, a love tap, an auto ballista, the lightning rod for the flying creatures, a gnome maintenance contract, the void wall, the wall grinder, the gnome repair crew, the finger trap, very effective, the fake one ring, and I really like this one. It says here, the other one R, so ring, presumably, and then the inside says, made in China. If the focus comes back, you'll see it. A bologna sandwich, a fire hose trap, and hammer time. And the peephole. Those are the traps. And the army cards. These are all army cards. And they tell you which creatures to spawn in a 2, 3, or 4 player game. So that's pretty straightforward. They're all different. There's some doubles in there as well, but you shuffle them and you simply draw cards and you read which creatures you need to spawn. So that's fairly straightforward. Let's move on to the tiles. Okay, so all the tiles have their name written on it in big yellow letters. So there is, of course, the rift, the point where the enemies are trying to escape to, the thing that you need to defend in this tower defense game, and all tiles are illustrated with the same art that's on the box. So there's the rift. There's a crossroads, so when you enter it, and I'm assuming you enter tiles from the bottom, if you hold it up so you can read it, and it has arrows here telling you where they go, and there's ticks on them as well, a couple of those. There's a gas chamber, and all the tiles, like I said, have an explanation on them. An acid bath, caltrops, a lava lake, a teleporter, Trapsburg, it gets traps automatically, a T-junction, and barbecue. So I've looked this up and I was wondering, so if you enter here, you go that way and that way. But apparently the rules are kind of free on how to use them, so you could also enter from this side. Because I've looked up if there is a certain point where you always enter, and it does look like you always enter from the bottom. You know, where the text is, and then the arrows tell you which way the monsters go. But I looked it up in the rule book, and the rules don't really tell you where to enter. It just explains what the tiles do. And, well, I'll show you in the maps book over here, just for an example. You have this map, and you can choose any tile you want here, and any T-junction here. And as you can see, you can enter from this side, according to this arrow. So you can enter from the barbecue side in this case, and then the arrows would point you this and that direction. So, and the armies enter here, here, and here, depending on which level you're playing. And so, yeah. You have to keep this as a reference during the game so you know where they enter. And I would have liked some kind of token that you could place on your tiles so you'd know where they entered from. And, well, Petersen during the Kickstarter had the suggestion of using the Cthulhu Wars gates that they had for the game. I think you could also order a pack of them. And they're basically round, like summoning stones around gates that you use in their game Cthulhu Wars, and you could place them there. And I thought, well, that's not really very thematic, and I might use something else, think of something else to use as a token, or maybe my Warhammer Quest gates, and they have these big double doors that you can place. So yeah, you know, that's, I would prefer to have had something, at least a cardboard, like a square cardboard token with a gate on it, printed on it. That would with an arrow or something. But okay, that's a minor thing. Everybody will think of something to indicate where they're coming from. But apparently you could just use any tile and you can place them in any direction. So you could basically enter each tile from each side, it seems. And yeah, so here as well, here's the same junction, and it's not very intuitive to me, but well, maybe if you play it, it'll come more clear. So here's an L junction. So you see, I would have thought you'd enter it from this side and then you'd go that or that way, like this, because this is obviously a gate. But the text is here, so that would suggest you could also enter from this side, maybe from both sides even. So, okay, not too intuitive, but also the stones, the artwork on the sides here that connects the tiles basically suggests that these are open from all four sides. And while this is clearly a passage, a straight passage with walls here, I'm not sure if you could not enter from that or that side. Well, the Botanical Gardens, which has an arrow here, so I'm guessing you can enter from all three sides and you'll always go that way. Cafeteria, stained hall, stained glass hall, some nice artwork. And I really like the art on these tiles. They really remind me of the video game. They're like, you know, these stills that they took from the game. So it really gets you in that, you know, the Orcs Must Die mood and that feeling. A grassy knoll. Ha ha ha. The lookout point. A narrow bridge. Now, I would assume that this is really a one-way tile, but you know, I'm not sure. A nice hall, slippery when wet, a spillway. See, and this one is a stairway which has the text here, so you'd assume they'd come from this way, but the arrow points that direction. So not all of these tiles are very clear to me. A straight shot, the bridge over troubled water, and finally Windows 0.1. Now, as you can see, there's still more humor in these, and it's a humorous game, just like the video game was, and I like that. It has to be your thing. Some people would prefer a more serious game, but this is a light-hearted, funny tower defense game. I'm not calling the board game light-hearted. I haven't played it yet, but the video game sure is. And I'm thinking, you know, this the feel is the same anyway. Okay, let's move on to the Unchained Edition. So this is the Unchained Edition. Okay, so as expected, more of the same. Another one of these sheets that tells you where the guys go. The big rule book. And assuming that it is exactly the same. So I'll just quickly go through that. It certainly does look the same. More maps. Now I'm kind of hoping these will be different, but nope, they are exactly the same. That is a little bit of a letdown. I would have hoped. But yeah, on the other hand, the games are basically the same. The only difference is the models that you get with them. So yeah, that was to be expected. So the heroes and the anti-heroes, I should say, in this game are the ball and chain, big orcish female, Bloodspike, a really cool looking orc, Midnight, who looks like a bit like a drow elf, but also a cat lady. Fun looking character. And so Winston. Okay, here are the order monsters, so to speak. Invaders. Another rift board, which is the same, with different art. More of these tokens. This also does look to be the same, except for perhaps this icon, because this is the Unchained icon. The other game had the Order icon. And there we have lots of miniatures. The equivalent to the Orc in the Order edition is one of these guys, these soldiers in the Unchained edition. Here's the Cat Lady, Midnight. Very nice, very thin tail, but it's bendy enough, so it hopefully won't break. There. More of these crossbow elves. Let's see if I can focus. Yep, there we go. Okay. Wow. It looks like this has more models, or at least bigger models, because the layout of the box is different. Here's a lion guy. Look at that. With a huge axe, big manes. These are big models. Very nice. So there's four of those in here, and there are four more, the eight lion dudes. Okay, another bag of the same dice, of course, more cards. Do these fit in this? Oh no, these were put in another direction. Now I'm not sure if that was meant. I'm thinking, no, that one fits, and this doesn't fit either, so that's a bit strange. I mean, this does fit, and the dice in the other box were in here, but well, these fit nicely like that, and I'm guessing these should be in here, like so. But okay, it has slots for stuff. So there's armies, traps, gear, and the heroes' starting weapons and advanced weapons. And like in the video game, traps and items are different. So yeah. Okay, I'm gonna check that out. When you played the War Mage, you had some different traps as when you played the Sorceress. So they kind of changed that in here as well. I'll check those out. But first, the models. Huge bag. Oh wow, some of these are gigantic. So here is a giant. And it is very, very large. Look at the spiked club on this one. Very nice. Awesome. Loving it. Here's a satyr running around. That's the equivalent to the running guy from the Order Edition. The kobold. Keep forgetting the name. Here is ball and chain. what was his name, Sir Winston? Yes, Sir Winston. And we already saw Midnight, so finally here is Bloodspike. Very mean looking, with some skulls and heads mounted on his armor. Okay, so we have more of these big giants. Oh, somebody snapped off of his base here. We'll see who that was. Another giant. Another satyr. Or satyr. Oh, this is cool. This is a bear. Also quite big. Let me see. Ah, it was one of the satyrs that came off, but it looks like the model hasn't suffered any damage, so I can just slot that back in and glue it. So, fortunately, no damages. Okay, more of these bears. And the last satyr. Okay, I'll show you the tiles, and they're probably going to be the same, and I'll show you the cards as well and see what's different. Okay, the cards, I'm gonna skip the armies because that's basically again the same. You just draw a card and it tells you how many monsters to spawn depending on the number of players you're playing with. So on to the weapons that are anti-heroes are using. Ball and Chain uses a ball and chain, spiked ball, and they have different names and different abilities. And Bloodspike uses the Orc Axe, the Troll Axe, the Ogre Axe. Midnight uses a blade, a poniard, and a Snickersnee. Interesting name. Sir Winston uses a talking sword, a shouting sword, and a singing sword. So those are their weapons and their gear. So we have an arcane bubble blower, awesome, a cursed ring, a dice bag. Now that is awesome. It actually has the Orcs Must Die dice. Oh, I skipped a few cards, they're sticking together a bit. There's a blessed ring and a chicken leg, always handy. There's a freeze pop amulet, cool. A spark chain, spring boots, a static cling, a stimpak, more vegetables of mending, they're coming, I think. The world's smallest violin. I mean, the humor in this game is awesome. That's just, I love that. An amethyst, bashing shield, a brain corral, a dryad statuette, frostbite from the frost ring from the video game, a goblin discount card, goblin goods, investment strategy, payday, pridefall, rat on a stick, ring of teleportation, a rolling stone, a specter ring, a talking skull ring again. The other one ring, it's basically the same again, only this one is actually red, the other one was blue, but it's also made in China. The thrice cursed ring, another toadstone amulet, a troll's ring, vegetables of mending, aqua regia, building code violation, bunny ears, goes well with the bunny paw. The burning coal, again, the crystal ball, a crystal shield, an icicle, the joy buzzer, the magic brick again, goblin tech, the mithril disc, also the same, the mood gem, the same, an ogre bomb, Orc Breath Mints. Ew. An Orc U Diploma from the Orc University. And a fake diploma. And there's a Screaming Skull Ring. Oh, and more. A Thrice Cursed Ring. Some of these cards stick together a bit, but they come loose easily. They came just out of the package, so that's normal, I think. Okay, traps. Focus, please. Yes, thank you very much. There's the support trap. Barricade, it says. Although this looks like the acid shooter from the video game. But okay, if this is a barricade, why didn't they put the barricade art on here? Maybe it's a mistake. I'm not sure. The Haymaker, also from the video game. Anti-magic field trap. Ah, the Firewalk, yes. Also very popular. The Poison Needle. Jack in the Box again. The Quarter Pounder again. Brain Freeze. The Ice Vent, yes. The Spring Trap, also a classic from the game. The Flip Trap. That's almost the same, I think, but it has a different description. The Snack Box. A Scythe. A Bucket of Heals. Good. The Goblin Toolkit. Frostbite. Another Barricade. Yeah, a higher level. The art is strange. The Steam Vent. The Doom Barrel. Yep. The Barrel Dispenser. The Freezer Burn. The Half Pounder. Ice Spray. The Lucky Headshot. The Spike Wall. The Swinging Mace, one of my favorites. I love to make a kill box with springing maces in the video game. Ogre Toolkit. Hobgoblin Toolkit. Autoballista. Explosive Runes. The Freezer Burn again. The Pound Pounder. Pop Quiz. The Boulder Shoot. And the Stunning Decor. The Chandelier Falling Down. And a Vampire Rune. So the traps are quite different. There are some of them that are the same, but lots of different ones. Okay, the tiles. The Acid Bath, the same. Caltrops, the same. Crossroads, two of them, yep. Gas Chamber, Lava Lake. Now the Rift has different art, obviously, because this is the Orc side of the Rift. So that's good. There's a Teleporter, it's just the same. Trapsburg. An Ice Tea Junction. This is different. So there is some difference. And the L Junction is also different. I see L Junction 2. Bridge Out. Also different. Creepy Attic. Also different. Gone to Seed. Well, it's at least nice to say that there is different art and different tiles. They probably do the same, basically, but you have some variation in art, at least. The Ice Box. Overgrown Walkway, Parking Garage, Rocky Road, Skating Rink. Standard Stairs. Storehäuser. Or something. Sub-Basement Level B. Substandard Stairs. The Manhole. Tiki Lights. Indeed. A Wooden Walkway. And a Rec Room. Well. So. While the function of the tiles stayed the same, you still get different artwork. So that's good. Especially when combining both games into a bigger map. It's gonna look great. So, there is also hero packs for both the Order and the Unchained Edition, which gives you 8 extra heroes to play with. So, let's have a look at what is inside of those. So first, it has the hero boards, of course. Let's see. Nicely packed. With the same awesome art on the back. So we have the Scarecrow, which in the video game was a different skin for the War Mage, Maximilian. And here is a different character, which is cool. And the same goes for the Bride, which was a different skin that you could use for the Sorceress. But now you have her as an extra character. There's Zoe, an apprentice sorceress, Hogarth, a warrior, Dobbin, a dwarf with explosives, Temper, and Tundra. Here's a guy called Adventure, the Adventurer, and that was all 8. Okay, let's have a look at the models. There. So they all come with their cards as well, of course. So their basic weapons, which you also saw on the character boards, are in here in 3 levels. Here is the Scarecrow model, the pumpkin head. Tundra, the large polar bear dude. If I can get my camera to focus, that would be nice. Yes, there we go. Temper, the Minotaur, with jewel-wielding hammers. The guy whose name I forgot already, because I don't know him from the video game. But he looks ready for action. The young apprentice with her spellbook and a little imp familiar. The dwarf with his backpack full of gear. Here's the sorceress in the bride costume, the big hair. Okay, and finally the adventurer. Onto the Unchained Edition Hero Pack. Eight more anti-heroes with their cards, which I will show you first. I love the quality of these. These are thick enough, you know, that they don't bend easily, and they have a nice finish, very bright artwork. Okay, so here's the ancestor, which is kind of like the evil sorcerer, who has a spear weapon, black paw, a big gnome, a gnoll with a claw. First Eye Blind, a Cyclops, with a cyclopean wand. Helter Swelter, a fire mage, it seems, with some dark magic there. Tududlu, another gnoll with hearts and a tutu. The Kobold King with his whip. And Smolder, the fire mage, wields red fire. Stinkeye, the Cyclops with the Cyclops staff, also known from the game. And that's those big guards, nice, with their weapons that we saw on the boards as well. I'll just leave them for now. And the models. A gnoll in a tutu, who would have thought? And the other gnoll, here he is with his wolverine claws. The Cyclops. The third eye blind dude. This is Smolder. The Kobold King. He looks really cool. And the Ancestor. So there you have 8 more anti-heroes for the Unchained Edition. But wait, there's more! This game also has add-on boss pack and a mini pack. A minion pack, I should say. And this adds more enemies and more bosses to your game. So let's quickly have a look at these minions first. Alright, so more minions, more of their cards in here. Let's see, where does it open? Here you go. Okay, so there's 2 cards that open like a book, as you can see. And well, they have the 4 different monsters that you can add with their abilities and what they do described here. Order enemies and unchained enemies with the artwork that also, just like the boxes, can be combined like so, which is great. So you get 1 box with enemies for both versions of the game. More of their army cards that we already know how they work. And in this box you have all these models. So there is the dwarf grenadier throwing bombs, grenades, and there's these goblin tinkerers who have this large explosive device, and they're dangerously tinkering with those. And these gnomes with their big steampunk glasses and their tools and a big mustache. And then finally these big cyclopses. So you get four of the smaller enemies and two of the big one that you can add to your game. So that's the minions, but there are also bosses. Who doesn't like more big miniatures, big bosses to add to the game? So let's have a look at those. First, the big cards, the reference cards. Okay, so what do we have? We have a Fire Lord. Swifty Hooves, a Satyr Boss. We have a Vitality, a Cyclops Shaman or some kind. An Earth Lord, a big Earth Elemental who breaks up into two Earth Elementals, smaller ones, just like in the game. And the Earth Elemental, when killed, breaks into two Earthlings. And the Earthling is the final stage. And when you kill it, it's gone. So that's those cards, and they all have the same background art. Okay, so the miniatures. So as you can see, the Earth Lord here is the biggest one. Big rock creature with this big fist raised. And when you kill it, you get two of these guys, a smaller mirrored version of the big guy. And then that breaks up into two as well, and you get four of these, the Earthling. Here's Swifty Hooves, the fast running satyr boss. This lava lord. Nice and big figure. And Vitality. And there you have them, all the bosses and extra minions. So that was all there was to unbox. It must have been the longest unboxing I have ever done. So that was the unboxing of Orcs Must Die, the board game. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching, and see you next time on Board Game Heaven.